Today, we're going to use Airbyte to sync data from Salesforce into Snowflake. First, we'll spin up a fresh Airbyte instance. Next, we'll configure Salesforce as a source of data. You'll notice the UI asks us for a few credentials. The Airbyte documentation has instructions on how to find credentials for each connector. Next, let's configure our destination. Let's use Snowflake as our warehouse. Once we enter our configuration, we'll be good to go. Now, Airbyte will show us the tables and columns that we can replicate into Snowflake. Let's deselect everything except for leads for now. Then we can choose how often we want to sync, and the first sync will start as soon as we click Setup Connection. After the sync has succeeded, let's go to the Snowflake UI, where we can see that our tables are now available. If we look for the leads table, we can view records we replicated. Let's see what happens when we make changes in Salesforce. Let's edit one of our leads. Here, I'll just add an email address. Then if we go back to the Airbyte UI, let's trigger a manual sync. After another successful sync, we can return to the Snowflake UI and show the leads table where our new change was appended. Thanks for watching, and we hope you'll try Airbyte today.